يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة.
So we test them with Rabee. We test them because a sign of a person's sunnah is his love of Rabee. If he hates Shaykh Rabee, then he is a mubtadi, ya ikhwan.
Okay, but at the same time, with your kind of view, and particularly when it comes to dealing with innovators, don't you feel like you're restricting yourself to maybe 3 or 4 shuyukh in the world, and you're being fanatical towards them? Whoever they declare to be an innovator, you're with them.
No, that's not the case. And there are people who are like that, I agree, okay. But I'm definitely not like that. I actually believe that ulama of the sunnah are all over the world. Some who I know and some I don't know. And the ones that I know, I hope, are more than the ones I know. And I actually believe that if a person, he bases his love and his hate, his allegiance on individuals, then that person is actually an innovator himself.
Okay.
And I'm going to read the statement of Imam Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah said, فَمَنْ جَعَلَ شَخْصًا مِنَ الْأَشْخَاصِ. Anyone who takes a particular person, غَيْرَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, other than the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, مَنْ أَحَبَّهُ, anyone who loves that person, وَوَافَقُهُ, and agrees with that person, كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ. He says, oh yeah, he's from Ahlul Sunnah. Why? Because he agrees with my Shaykh.
Yeah.
Anyone who does that and says, you're Ahlul Sunnah because you agreed with our Shaykh, you agreed with our Imam. Anyone who does that, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, وَمَنْ خَالَفَهُ, and anyone who opposes that Shaykh, you say he's an innovator because he opposed the Shaykh. وَمَنْ خَالَفَهُ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبِدْعَةِ وَالْفُرْقَةِ. That you're an innovator. You're causing disunity to the Ummah because you went against our Imam. كَمَا يُوجَدُ ذَلِكَ فِي الطَّوَائِفِ. As it has, this is present in some deviated groups in the religion. وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ, and other than that, كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ وَالضَّلَالِ وَالتَّفَرُّقِ. You are from the innovators now. You are misguided. Of course they are. Anyone who bases love and hate on other than the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that which the Ummah have unanimously agreed upon, anyone who bases love and hate on other than the Quran and the Sunnah, and that which the Ummah have united upon, then he is from min ahli al-bida'i wal-dalali wal-furqah.
Okay.
Amma wal-tafarruq. He is a person of the, whether he screams I'm from the people of the Sunnah and I am from the Imams of the Sunnah and I'm upon Salafiyya and I'm this and that, he can give himself those fancy names. He is an innovator himself. He is misguided himself and he is from Ahlul Furqa, those Ahlul Tafarruq. So that's something I really want people to understand. There are scholars of the Sunnah in India. There are scholars in the Sunnah in Europe. There are scholars in the Sunnah in America.
Europe.
All of it, I don't know them. I can't. Okay, I cannot eliminate everything.
Yeah.
There could be scholars of Sunnah in America. There could be scholars in China. There could be scholars in Australia. There could be scholars of the Sunnah in, what do you call it, Africa. I can't speak.
Okay.
And just because I don't know something, as the ulama, they say, just because you're ignorant of something, that doesn't mean it doesn't exist. Your ignorance of something doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. So I'm saying that, alhamdulillah, the people of the Sunnah are a lot. They don't have to sign up. They don't have to call a particular person. They don't have to sign a letter of agreement. All that they need to come with is they have to follow the Quran and the Sunnah, and every interpretation they give for the Quran and the Sunnah has to be based on what the Sahaba said.
Okay.
That's all it is.
Even if you don't call yourself, for example, Salafi.
You don't have to call yourself Salafi. Wallahi, you don't have to call yourself Salafi. No, you don't have to call yourself Ahlul Sunnah if you want to. Rather, if you call yourself Salafi and you don't follow the Quran and the Sunnah and that which the pious predecessors is upon, and you give yourself a Salafi, you're not a Salafi. The name doesn't change anything.
Okay.
لا عبرة, the scholars they say, لا عبرة بالألفاظ والمباني. There's no reality to wordings and terms. إنما العبرة بالمعاني. That which we look at is the meaning. We look at your action. We look at how do you follow the Salaf. Are your actions, like there are a group of people who say, I'm Salafi right now, and they shout that we're Salafi. But for them, the reality and the truth is, they have love, and they have hate, and they have allegiance on a particular person, or a particular, or 2-3 shaykhs. وَهَذَا حَقْ لَا مِرْيَةَ فِي. There's no debate about that. That's the truth, that's the reality. Though, you know what you can do? You can oppose if you want to. The Salaf. You can oppose the Salaf if you want to. But if you don't oppose, if you agree with their shaykh, you're from the Ahlul Sunnah and you're from Fiqh to Najiyah and you're Salafiyyah. That's the reality of some group of people out there.
This Shaykh is also one of your Shaykhs.
I mean, I respect the Shuyukhs of Ahlul Sunnah in general. That doesn't mean I agree with everything a person says. I don't believe every single person a Shaykh says that he's Haqq and he is I don't believe that. I believe يُؤْخَذُ مِنْ قَوْلِهُ وَيُرَدْ. I take some of his speech when he goes in accordance to the Kitab and the Sunnah, and I reject it when he goes against the Kitab and the Sunnah. I'm not fanatic over any individual.
Okay.